Hello everyone, this is your host, Cher. Today I want to share with you this letter which was found in the dead body of a soldier killed in action during the war. He addressed the letter to God. Dear God, I have never spoken to you, but now I want to say, how do you do? You see, God, they told me you did not exist. And I, like a fool, believed all this. Last night, from a shell hole, I saw your sky. I figured right then that they had told me a lie. Had I taken time to see the things you made, I would have known they weren't calling a spade a spade. I wonder, God, if you'll take my poor hand. Somehow I feel you understand. Funny how I had to come to this hellish place before I had time to see your face. I guess there really isn't much more to say, but I'm sure, God, that I met you today. I guess the 0 hour will soon be here, but I'm not afraid since I know you're near. The signal. Well, God, I'll have to go. I like you lots. This I want you to know. I'm sure this will be a horrible fight. Who knows, I may come to your house tonight. I wonder, God, if you'd wait at your door. Look, I'm crying, me shedding tears. I'll have to go now, God, goodbye. But since I have met you, I'm not afraid to die. This is a very touching prayer by this soldier on his last night on earth. What is hopeful and beautiful about this is that before he died, he was able to find his God. He was able to talk to God. Did you know that God created us humans for fellowship so that we can talk to him, so that he can have fellowship with someone like him who can create? How wonderful it is that God has created us in his own image. That's an amazing thing. He has created us with his own DNA. Not even the DNA of angels, but God's own DNA. He has put his own DNA in us. He created us out of the dust, out of the earth, but he has put his own spirit, his own image in us. That is so wonderful. We are so blessed and honored that God chose us, who are nothing, to be the recipient of his glory. The sky, the earth, the sun, the moon, even though they don't say a word, every day they are witnessing to the existence of God. Just the fact that there's so much beauty and color and wonder in the world is proof enough that there is a God. And the truth is that whenever we are in trouble, when we are in really big trouble, even an atheist would say, God, would cry out to God. It is in our innate nature that we would cry out to God when we are in trouble. And it is wonderful that he would understand. He would understand everything that we feel. And we don't have to pretend. We don't have to say things that we don't mean. We can just be real. We can just be honest with him. That's wonderful about our God. And if we accept God as God, worship him, give our lives to him, invite him before we make any decision, talk to him about all our problems and difficulties and things that we go through, he would listen, he would understand. If we ask him for wisdom, how to go about our day, how to live the best life possible, the best way possible, he would answer our prayers because he loves us and he wants what is best for us. Today, I encourage you also to talk. It may not be your last night or day on earth, but we never know when we will die. So give your lives to him today. Talk to God as you would to a best friend. He is there. He will listen and he loves you more than anyone else does. Talk to him today.